السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله لا إله إلا الله
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وأطهر المرسلين شفيع المذنبين وحبيب رب العالمين محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم In the name of Allah, the compassionate, the most merciful, all praise is due to Allah. We bear witness that no one is worthy of worship but Allah, and we bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is indeed his final messenger. The best of speech is the book of Allah, and the best of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who listen to the best of speech, the book of Allah, and follow its commandments. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who come to know the best of ways, the way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and make us amongst his followers. Allahumma ameen. Allahumma ameen. Allahumma ameen. Ya ahbaba Rasulillahi salawatu rabbi wa salamu alayhi, yaqulu rabbuna jalla wa ala. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, it is during the month of Ramadan that this Quran has been sent down. But the Quran was sent down with a purpose. Hudan linnas, as a means of guidance to people. And this statement is mentioned in numerous places in the Quran. Alif lam ra, kitabun anzalnahu ilayka لِتُخْرِجَ النَّاسَ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. This is a book that we have sent down to thee, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لِتُخْرِجَ النَّاسَ غَايَ, for the purpose of that you may take people out of the depth of darknesses إِلَى النُّورِ, into light. And many times the Quran encourages the believers, you've got to read the book. You've got to read the book. You've got to read the book with understanding. You've got to read the book with pondering. To think that Allah is going to bless us simply because I am just merely reading, that would be an insult. Wallahi, that would be an insult. To think that our relationship with the Quran is for us to have the ability to utter the words of the Quran and that is the end of it, that would be an insult to the Quran. And in numerous places Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala implores the believers, this book has got to be read with tadabbur. You have to read the book, but it has to be read with understanding, with reflection. Where no كتاب أنزلناه إلى كتاب أنزلنا مبارك ليتدبروا آياته. This is a book that has been sent down to you. It is a blessed book. For what purpose? ليتدبروا آياته. So that people may ponder upon the signs, the verses that are in this book. And subhanAllah, the more we ponder, the more wonders that we find in this book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm just going to share with you what we call a lafda. You know something, the way that the Quran speaks. See, the Quran speaks many times so simply and easily, but don't be fooled by the initial simplicity of it. The book is easy, but it's not effortless. It's got to be read. It seems to be simple. And the more effort you put into it, the deeper and the more the book seems to be offering. So for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, وَأَوْحَى رَبُّكَ إِلَى النَّحْلِ أَنِ اتَّخِذِي مِنَ الْجِبَالِ بُيُوتًا وَمِنَ الشَّجَرِ وَمِمَّا يَعْرِشُونَ. Your Lord has inspired the bees, the honey bees, make for yourselves places of habitations. مِنَ الْجِبَالِ, up in the mountains. مِنَ الشَّجَرِ, trees. وَمِمَّا يَعْرِشُونَ, and from the roofs and ceilings that people construct. ثُمَّ كُلِي مِن كُلِّ الثَّمَرَاتِ. And then Allah continues to inspire this honeybee, eat of all kinds of truth, of fruits. فَسْلُكِي سُبُولَ رَبِّكِ ذُلُلًا. And then take the path, the different path that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has laid down for you. يَخْرُجُ مِن بُطُونِهَا شَرَابٌ مُخْتَلِفٌ أَلْوَانٌ فِيهِ شِفَاءٌ لِلنَّاسِ. Out of its bellies comes out a drink with variant colors. In it there is indeed healing, a source, a medicinal source for the people. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةً لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Indeed, in this, there is a sign for people who ponder. The verse seems to be simple, but then the Quran hints and says, it does seem to be simple, but there is a hint in there in that you've got to ponder. You've got to reflect what in the world is going on. And the theme here in these two little verses is these honeybees. SubhanAllah, honeybees are some of the most amazing, amazing creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Amazing. Honeybees are the only insects in the world that produce anything that can be consumed by us humans. In fact, honeybees are not just important because they produce honey. One third of the fruit
that we eat is possible because of pollination that is being carried out by the honeybees. A honeybee, subhanAllah, we are told, lives anywhere between 5 to 7 weeks. During this time, a honeybee is able to produce 1/12 of a teaspoon. 1/12 of a teaspoon. In its lifetime, a honeybee visits anywhere between 2,000 to 2,500 trees. Roses and what have you. See, we're not going to spend the time talking about the honeybees, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam added on to this reflection. Because see what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam does is that he expounds on what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. That's his job description. لِتُبَيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ. So that you may clarify to people what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down to them. Listen to what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ إِنَّ مَثَلَ الْمُؤْمِنِ كَقِطْعَةِ الذَّهَبِ كقطعة الذهب تحرق فلا تنقص والذي نفس محمد بيده إن مثل المؤمن عند الله كمثل النحلة إذا أكلت أكلت طيبة وإذا وضعت وضعت طيبة وإذا قعدت على عود لم تكسره ولم تفسده. صلوا على رسول الله. In the hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the parable of a believer is like that of a piece of gold. So a believer is like a piece of gold. Well, the owner of that piece of gold may blows into it. But the blowing on all that fire that comes its way neither diminishes it, nor does it become less in weight. It never changes nor diminishes. The value doesn't change. It's gold, man. It's always good. The value does not go down because of this. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, such as a believer. No matter what happens, that value in the believer is never lost. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and the parable of a believer is like that of a honeybee. A believer is like a honeybee, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us. How so, Prophet of Allah, you ask? He said, إِذَا أَكَلَتْ أَكَلَ الطَّيِّبَةً. When that honeybee consumes anything, it only consumes that which is good. Where do you find honeybees? Be by the garden. They be by the roses. They be by the beautiful fields. You won't find them by the trash. That's not where they belong. Where are they at? And they are just visiting. Their environment is beautiful. Where they live is beautiful. Where they visit is beautiful. Their association is always beautiful. Said, إِذَا أَكَلَتْ أَكَلَ الطَّيِّبَةً وَإِذَا وَضَعَتْ وَضَعَ الطَّيِّبَةً. And whenever anything comes out of it, only good comes out of it. It's honey, man. Sweetest thing. And so is a believer. Whenever that believer utters anything, says, only good comes out of you. And then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَإِذَا قَعَدَتْ عَلَىٰ عُودٍ لَمْ تَكْسِرُ وَلَمْ تُفْسِدُ. And when it lands on a branch, it neither breaks it, nor does it destroy it. Wherever a believer goes, they are a source of blessings. You know, you ask farmers, say, farmers are always worried about insects. But a farmer sees a honeybee in their field, or they're happy. Don't touch it, man. That honeybee, leave it there. The honeybee is the best news that can happen to my field. Because I know only good will come out of this honeybee. وَإِذَا قَعَدَتْ عَلَىٰ عُودٍ لَمْ تَكْسِرْهُ وَلَمْ تُفْسِدْهِ. It lands on a branch. It neither breaks it, nor does it corrupt it. That's beautiful. Wallahi, that is beautiful. To think of our deen The way that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam so beautifully simplifies these things. It's nice that these are the kind of parables that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam uses to describe what it means to be a good Muslim, what it means to be a good believer. So he sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us these things, what can be deduced from he sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling us. A believer only associates with good company. And that's a must, especially for the young people here. That's a must, associating ourselves and putting ourselves in good environments. Like the honeybee, that's what they do. And then the other thing is, whatever comes in, not just in terms of food, the kind of things that we expose ourselves to, things that come to us through our ears or through our eyes, we only allow that which is good to come in. We're not consumed by a good amount of the filth that is out there. Then he sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and whatever comes out of a believer, it comes out good. Believers pay attention to what they say, because words have consequences. Believers are thoughtful, they are deliberate, they think about their statements, fully cognizant as to how it is going to impact those who are going to be around them. Note in the hadith said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was talking to some of the, you know, the people who fled Mecca after the conquest of Mecca. They have done so much wrong to the Muslims, and they felt that the only chance that they have is to run away. One of the people that ran away was Ikrimah ibn Abi Jahl. Ikrimah, the son of Abu Jahl, the notorious person that opposed Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam while in Mecca. He ran away. His wife though, Umm Hakim, she came and she said, Prophet of Allah, I really like your message. I'm a believer. I also care for my husband, Prophet of Allah. I want you to give me something so that when I see him, you know what, he's being granted clemency. So the Prophet ﷺ said, go tell her. She said, Prophet of Allah, he won't believe me. He might think that this is an entrapment. So the Prophet ﷺ takes off his amama. He takes off his turban. And in the Arab culture, that was not something that people do. So he said, go and show him this as a sign of honor. She catches her husband. She said, you can come back. Muhammad ﷺ won't do anything to you. I don't believe you. She shows him the turban. That was the sign. Man comes back with a changed heart. Comes back with a changed heart, and the Prophet ﷺ sees him coming. Now remember, he is the son of Abu Jahl. So now listen to the instructions that he sallallahu alaihi wasallam gives to the people around him. He said, يَأْتِيكُمْ عِكْرِمَ الْآنِ مُؤْمِنًا. Ikrimah is coming, and I know the man is coming with a changed heart, and most likely he is going to declare his shahada. But you all listen to this, he said, فَلَا تَسُبُّوا أَبَاهُ. لَا تَسُبُّوا أَبَاهُ. Said, do not say anything negative about his father. I know who his father is. La tasubbu abah. That's not what we do. We get our principles from the beautiful teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, think of this, a believer is like a honeybee. A believer is like a piece of gold. A believer is somebody fihi shifa'un linnas. Ikhwani, this is just amazing. See, when honeybees give, doesn't matter who drinks that honey, a believer, non-believer, a good person, a bad person, the idea is what? I am going to do good for the benefit of those who are around me. Whether they are worth it or not, that's a different story. My job is to be good to those who are around me. And Ramadan comes in to further emphasize and bring out and refine that spirit in the believer. Brothers and sisters, let us not limit our fasting to the idea that we did not eat and did not drink the entire day. Wallahi, to many people around the world, that's a lifestyle, man. Many people around the world, that is their lifestyle. Not, they have Ramadan every single day of their lives. Ibn Mas'ud is asked after the departure of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كَيْفَ كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَقْبِلُونَ رَمَضَانَ فِي عَهْدِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ How is it that you met, anticipated the arrival of the month of Ramadan during the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? What do people do? Shopping? Clean the house? Get everything done? He said, وَاللَّهِ مَا كَانَ أَحَدُنَا يَجْرُ أَنْ يَدْخُلَ عَلَيْهِ رَمَضَانَ وَفِي قَلْبِهِ ذَرَّةُ حِقْدٍ عَلَىٰ أَخِيهِ He said, man, we wouldn't even dare that the month of Ramadan would come upon us with any malice in our hearts towards anyone out there. I am going to clean, but I am going to clean my heart. That's such a beautiful way of looking at it. You know, subhanAllah, during summer time, I'm very sure that this is also the case in Canada, people have garage sales. People have garage sales. In the US, it is such a big industry, we get about 90,000 garage sales every single weekend. It's an industry of about $4 billion. $4 billion are spent on garage sales. I love garage sales. I go and I just love to visit garage sales. Just to see all kinds of junk that people are trying to get rid of. More interesting than the junk that they're trying to get rid of are the people who are interested in that junk, subhanAllah. But they say every now and then, you know, people have garage sales because they want to keep their garages clean. They want to get rid of the clutter. Every now and then, my brothers and sisters, it's a good idea to have a garage sale in our hearts. Wallahi, a lot of useless stuff is kept in here. Absolutely useless. Occupies space for no good reason. He said, the month of Ramadan comes in, man, we better got to do some cleaning. And where is that cleaning supposed to? Not just physically. He said, man, you need also to do some cleaning in our hearts as well. It is unfathomable that we would actually think that we are enjoying the month of Ramadan, but our social relationships are suffering. Honeybees don't do that. Well, amazingly, honeybees, subhanAllah, say that, some studies say that honeybees don't sleep. They're busy doing work all the time. They communicate via each other by dancing. Meet somebody and start dancing in their presence. Very difficult to be angry if you're dancing in somebody else's presence. So that they just, the way that they communicate, the way that they cooperate with one another. You know, they say that when a honeybee visits a flower, it leaves a mark. So that when another honeybee comes, does not waste time on that flower. I've already got the juice out of there. This has been taken care of. Find something else to do. Similarly, our social lives cannot be suffering if we want to be spiritually uplifted. If you have a relationship that is not doing well, wallahi, now is the time to take care of it. Ya Rasulullah, ma ahabbu al-a'mali ila Allah. Prophet of Allah, what is absolutely the most beloved deed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What does the Prophet say? Pray in the masjid, do your this, fast Ramadan. Prophet of Allah, what is really the most beautiful deed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves and appreciates? The Prophet says what? Islah bayn al-nas. Mending broken relationships. Mending broken relationships is a priority to the believer. May this Ramadan help us in mending our relationships. If any of our relationships are suffering, may this month of Ramadan comes as a source of shifa, healing to it. وَخَيْرُهُمَ الَّذِي يَبْدَأُ بِالسَّلَامِ It's human nature that, you know, the more friction or the more interaction we have with people, most likely we will have friction with them, most likely that will lead into tension. But then the Prophet ﷺ said, the best amongst the people are those who initiate peace. Please do not wait for them to initiate peace. Be that person that initiates peace. So that we can say, and during this month of Ramadan, not only was I healed spiritually, but I also did better socially. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us in understanding, Ya Rabb al-Alamin. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على رسوله المصطفى وعلى من بآثاره اقتفى. إن شاء الله after the prayers we're going to have a janazah prayer. A brother faster has passed away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless his soul, Ya Rabbil Alameen. I've not met this brother, but I just read a couple paragraphs that were said about him. The brothers from Indonesia came to the city in 2015. He's left the wife and a daughter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them, Ya Rabbil Alameen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them lots and lots of patience, Ya Rabbil Alameen. You know, in the hadith we are told that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us. He says, مَنْ صَبَّرَ مُصَابًا فَتَصَبَّرْ فَلَهُ مِثْلَ أَجْرِ. He said that whosoever comes and consoles and comforts a person that has been impacted by a calamity, and because of what they said or what they did, it gave these people comfort. He said that Allah will bring comfort upon you as much as comfort you brought into other people. Can you imagine the kind of things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves and appreciates? So after the battle of Mu'ta, the Prophet ﷺ comes in with the army. It was a bad battle. Lots of believers died there. So the kids in Medina, everybody is coming to looking for their dad. Women out there looking, I want to see my husband. So the kids are running towards their children, towards their parents. Comes the children of Ja'far. Ja'far ibn Abi Talib. And they say Ja'far ibn Abi Talib resembled the Prophet ﷺ so much that from a far distance, his children thought the Prophet ﷺ was their father. So they started running towards him. And he sallallahu alayhi, he's crying and kissing them. His wife shows up and she said, Ya Rasulullah, Ja'far. Said Prophet of Allah, Ja'far. He doesn't answer. He is crying. And she implores further, Ya Rasulullah, Ja'far. Prophet of Allah, Ja'far, what happened to him? And then when he didn't answer, she knew. So she looked at her kids and she said, Ya Rasulullah, man li ha'ula? She said, Prophet of Allah, who's going to look after them? My kids are orphans now. Listen to what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. Now the idea is to comfort people. So what does he say? He said, Al yutma takhafi alayhim wallahi inni abuhum min ba'di abihim. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, are you afraid that they're going to be orphans and fatherless? By Allah, from today I am their father after the departure of their father. Speaking about comfort, that's what believers do. We comfort each other. These are the type of things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appreciates and loves and likes, and these are the best expressions of religiosity. Wallahi, these are the best expressions of religiosity. So the brother never missed a Friday prayer at, I believe, the other center. He was known for his generosity. And inshallah, when we depart this world, that's how people remember us. Man, I remember that, but I remember that sister, always smiling, they're always nice, they're always comforting people, they always loved serving other people, they were always doing this and that, so that on our day of departure, people are genuinely sad to miss us. be it this brother, or if any of our loved ones have passed away, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless their souls. If any of our loved ones are not feeling well, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them a speedy recovery. If any of our relationships are broken, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us in mending them. For all of our brothers and sisters around the world who are oppressed, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease their pain, ya Rabbil Alameen. All those who are wrongly imprisoned, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala free and liberate them, ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to benefit and maximize our benefit from this month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us understanding. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who love the Quran and are loved by the Quran and they love to ponder the Quran, ya Rabbil Alameen. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا تقبل منا صيامنا وقيامنا وصلاتنا يا أرحم الراحمين يا الله اللهم يا رب إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقم الصلاة.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.